Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Afia Nadiralia Putri, and today I will be the presenter for the abstract ID AIC 2020 AMOS 92 with entitled Assessing Factors That Affecting Sustainable Tourism Review. Okay, the next slide. So for the introduction, as we can see here, tourism is a rapidly growing phenomenon that has grown to become one of the largest industry. And based on the number of international tourist arrival, it's continued to increase to reach 1.3 million tourist arrival in 2019. And this number is continued to grow, but because of the COVID-19 pandemic, there is a decline but we are still hope that it's reaching estimated 2 million international tourists in 2030. So according to a number of studies and report, mass tourism activities are thought to be responsible to the most severe negative impacts, such as the large-scale tourism cannot meet the requirement for the long-term tourism sustainability. To mitigate the tourism negative impact, it is necessary to develop and also to manage tourism activities in the sustainable manner. And the pandemic has hampered Indonesia tourism development, and it is sure the sustainable tourism trend will be continue to increase, especially in the new normal condition. It is hoped that after pandemic, there will be a new trend in traveling, with tourists paying more attention into tourism protocol related to health, safety, comfort, and also nature conservation. Okay, and this is the research novelty and objective. So based on literature review, there are numerous barriers to developing sustainable tourism, including regulation, lack of infrastructure, uncertainty in business climate, natural disaster, market condition, human resource efficiency, innovation, and also tourism area operators. And this paper theoretically review the concept of the sustainable tourism to increase the dynamism and also better align theory and practice. And this is the methodology. So the first one, we are setting the research objective. After that, identify the key research themes to date and challenge for future research, and evaluating the concept and also factor to the sustainable tourism, and draw insight from the literature review. So based on the literature review, we get 6 factors that associated with sustainable tourism. The first one is regulation. After that, market condition, environmental condition, organization readiness, innovation, and the last one is perceived risk, benefit, and risk. And this is about the regulation. So based on the literature review, the government is responsible for making all strategic choice regarding the tourism development. And government policies are extremely likely to influence a plan that is being developed or has been already developed. According to DINICA in 2018, the government can play a role or have obligation in things such as the rules of land, tourism area development, and the use and the land use in terms of tourism development. And as of this writing, there has been a very little debate on the sustainable tourism policies and also standards. And this is about the market awareness. So according to the Ministry of Tourism and Creative Economy, COVID-19 pandemic period has accelerated the development of the sustainable tourism. According to the findings from Brandley in 2011, some tourists are still unwilling to pay for a premium for the sustainable tourism. Because of that, the remedy is to promote approach of attempting to alter tourism behavior patterns by expanding their knowledge and also the sustainable and also the environmental consciousness in order to foster the purposeful empathy. Okay, and this is about the environmental condition. So in the midst of the issue of the global warming, the impact of which is now being felt more and more often by us, even starting in touch of European and also American countries. So the government policy direction actually benefit the capitalism and endanger the future of the environment. So according to Azzori in 2020, action is required in response to the climate change and also its future consequence. And destination management is required to mitigate all the natural and man-made disaster to contribute to the development of more resilient environment. And this is about the organization readiness. So the concept of the sustainable tourism actually has been implemented in Indonesia. And currently the Ministry of Tourism and the Economy has implemented certification concepts such as for the Indonesian Sustainable Tourism Award, Indonesian Tourism Village Award, and Indonesian Tourism Village Certification. But some regions in Indonesia still developing and also still not have the certification. And for the example, Bali now become the model of the sustainable tourism model. And the Balinese people have the level, high level of the communal consciousness, learn from crisis, and also seek for equilibrium. Okay, and this is about the innovation. So actually the tourism COVID-19 pandemic make the innovation more and more increasing. And to introduce the innovation, such as the technology has the potential to transform how business operate and how they meet the customer expectation. And additionally, technology can assist in developing and also delivering the new product service. And as we all know, maybe virtual tourism is also can be used to benefit the company without requiring the increased mobility due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, and this is the last one. The last factor is about perceived risk and benefit. So as we all know, to develop the sustainable tourism, there is need a cost. So cost management is intrinsically linked to the intervention and the concept of market value. And technology also has become the perceived pervasive in the field of the travel marketing and distribution. And that's all about the presentation. Okay, and this is if you have question, and also you can have a call to the corresponding author, Yuliani Dwi Lestari, and this is her email, yulianidwi@sbmitbic.id. Okay, and that's all about the presentation. Thank you. Have a good day.